Hello and welcome to a Minecraft one-shots video I'm making. I'm creating an auto-enchanting table and trying to improve upon it and create a cool contraption to where I can have infinite experience, so you can watch along. A lot of it I haven't perfected, and I'm kind of thinking as I go with a lot of it, so you can watch and then help me in the comments refine it or make it better. So I could have some stuff that could be simplified, or you know what I mean? I might be overdoing it in some ways, but let me show you what I have here. It's an auto-enchanting area that should be really cool to just, you know, make. It's just a souped-up auto-enchanting area. I'm using some tanks from the Open Blocks mod. They're hidden down below the anvil and under that auto enchantment table, which is also by Open Blocks. You can see there's some experience in it because I preloaded the tank with a little bit. This is the auto anvil. Also, a lot of this is Open Blocks. Auto anvil from Open Blocks. The XP bottler from Open Blocks mod, and there's an XP drain on here, so I can come up here if I have, like, I'm level 1. Actually, I have a little bit, so I'll show you. I'll step on it, and it drains into that tank. And you can look at the tank, and you can see that it took my measly two little bits of experience and filled that tank up. These are Biblio Woods mahogany bookcases, and I loaded them with enchanted books. I think you have to have enchanted books. So those are loaded up there. And what I'm going to do, though, is use Tinker's Construct XP berries and try to create an infinite supply of experience by using these fluid ducts from Thermal Expansion that go... That's for later use. It's a giant cavern I dug out. You can see it's connected to the side of the tank at that point. And we're going up here. So what I'm doing up here, which we'll be working on, and I'll probably need to refine it, but these are my initial plans. What I have here is vacuum hoppers from Open Blocks attached all along here to this fluid duct. I've got, what, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 of them right now. So what I want to do is try to get a method to auto-pick, and I think I can use what's called an autonomous activator. Well, I have one on me right here. Autonomous activator from Thermal Expansion. And, use that with the Essence Berry Bush from Tinker's Construct. And I'm thinking, here's what I am initially thinking. If I did, I could utilize one row of hoppers for two rows of essence berry bushes. I could double up, I think, because I could have... Actually, let's do it this way. Let me break all this down. Because I wanted it to be kind of efficient and tightly organized. I'm not even sure if I actually have these book shelves placed correctly. I've got 3, well, they're stacked as well. So I got 6 in the back, but I meant 3. I have, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, like that. And I think that gives me my maximum amount possible for an enchantment level. So I'm wondering, I'm trying to decide if I want to move that to this block, move the pipe to this block, or keep it there. And I think I'll keep it for now. Whoops. So I'll go back to what I was doing originally. This is going to end up extending over. Let me use dirt for now. I don't think you have to plant the essence berry bushes on dirt. I think you can plant them right on concrete as well. But here's what I'm thinking. A row right here. Whoops, I'm beating myself up with them. They act like cacti or cactuses too, I guess. So be careful about that. So, I did it again. So I'll be using the Thomas Activator. I'll have to turn that with a wrench. Oh, I did that wrong. I want the row out back here. Am I destroying them? Oh well. Okay. There. So. No, we don't need that row there. Unless I want to add onto it. Okay. And so the activators will be. Oh, this destroys things, I think. I don't like that. Let me get a bunch of autonomous activators. Whoops. Doesn't matter which way they're facing right now. So they actually might need to be above. It might be too not high enough. They might get sucked up by the vacuum hoppers at this level. But they might need to be one higher than the they might need to be up there. Well, we can always try it this way. So I have to go from my bad memory to try to see how to program these. I think we could use the regular wrench, couldn't we? Oh wait, whoops. Let's get one working right now. Oops. And then we'll work on the rest once we figure out how to correctly get the first one. So, didn't I turn that off? So, a couple of those have started to grow. Well, hopefully we can get this to work properly. I'll go ahead and move them around here. Yes, I know, I'm beating myself up. Okay. Okay. Now, the autonomous activator in this position might actually be in the way, because it might pick them, and it might not eat the berry and spit it out the back. What I was originally thinking is the activators will eat the berry from here, pull it in, and then spit it out behind it, and where the vacuum hopper will suck it in. And I was thinking this might be a somewhat efficient method to have two rows of these activators like this, and that way I'm using one row of vacuum hoppers per two rows of activators and essence bushes. I don't know how long it'll take for that to grow, but in the meantime, let's take a look at the innards of one of these. This is a right click, which I think is what we want. That's how we would pick the berry, by right clicking on it. This is basically acting like a person clicking something, this autonomous activator. Wow, they put in a tutorial. And I don't even think this needs powered, because as you can see, it's moving. So let's see, configuration. We want to use this simply. To be a very simple method. I want to see how it works the way it is. I might just want to extend the roof of this too, because what I want to do, because here's what I'll be doing. I'll be bringing this way, right? So we can get another row over here. I have no idea how long it'll take to actually grow one of these to test it. We kind of have to wait. And I'm trying to think in the meantime. That's the problem with testing this now. I don't know if we need a pipe. Because I'm pretty sure we can't. I'm going on memory from a dire. This is the Direwolf 20 1.6.4 mod pack, by the way. I'll put that right in the description because I forgot to mention that at the beginning of this video. They're definitely growing. Those two grew up there. That one there. Okay, this has stuff in it. Why does this have... I was breaking stuff and it was sucking stuff right into it. Okay, so those are obviously working. Oh, I see. We have to set the output. It's like, I'm thinking this is the bottom, right? Yes, okay. I forgot to make the connection. Item output. Right, yeah. So let me get a better view of that so you can see. Oh, you can't now. Let's see. Well, we can look at this one here. Okay, so we'll do this one to show you. There, see? There's the output now. Right there. That's what I had forgotten. Those, so we need to set this one. And then this one. I think that's all of them. I think that's all of them. Okay. Alright, that's really grown up. That's full grown there. So let's see. Let's see if it automatically works without any pre-configuring. Once that grows. See, the one thing I'm a little worried about is that the vacuum hopper is neat because it'll suck in items thrown near it. But I wonder if at the same level, I wonder, you know, if it'll pick those up or if they'll kind of like fall down here and just not get sucked up. Okay. Because if this method works for now, I'll extend this method out here to, let's see, let's get some more dirt. This will be another, okay. This will be a row of... I don't know why those don't stack. These will be autonomous activators here. Oops. This will be extended to here. No, it would be out more. To here. Because we'll have more autonomous activators. See, whoops, is that the same level? Yeah. And then more vacuum hoppers. We got 1, 2, 3, whoops, 3, 4, and 5. And then we can program these. Whoops. Two, 3, 4, and one more here. 5. Okay. See, that's how we'll do it, and then we'll have another row of activators and berries. There, like that. Let me make it day here. So we got 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. 5 on the other side. Let's check this. Did it pick anything? Whoops. Nothing. What's this here? Oh, you know what? This is the item output. This is XP outputs. So, we might have to reset. We might have to go back. Okay. It's denoted by a green band. Green colored band on the bottom. Okay, nice. It looks like it's already on. That one's not on. Whoops, that's the item output, that's why. Well, these aren't on. That's just weird. We can double check them if I have to. Oh no! I keep messing up. Okay, I believe those are all set. So we need to set XP. Okay. On and last one here. On. Okay. Now, one thing we can check is we can keep an eye on the levels. I don't know how that lost a level. I think it's because I have this set. I have these machines set to auto suck it up. So let's take auto drink off of this stuff. Actually, let me turn this stuff off. That way we can definitely keep track. Oh, I see. It's showing two there and one there. So it's like depending on which part of the tank, which area of the tank. Well, we'll keep track of that. It was showing two back there, one here. So when this stuff starts growing, hopefully we'll be able to figure this out. I'll just keep it making scaffolding here. Okay. And if we didn't have this set to an output, these vacuum hoppers would store experience right here. Okay, that's fully grown, that's fully grown. And so the idea is to just take this kind of build and make it bigger. That way, because it does take a long time for the XP berries to grow. And so if we expand and have a whole bunch of them, we're going to be getting them at a better rate of speed. So let me check that and that. Whoops. Maybe I should go ahead and turn item outputs off. Right? We don't need. Now why was that off? Let's think about this. Item. Okay, we want only a green band. Okay. That's all we want. We don't need the item output to be on. So if you think of ways things I'm doing wrong or ways I can improve this, please let me know in the description or in the comments section. Or let me know on Twitter or I'm also kind of toying with this idea on a different Direwolf 20 1.6.4 game. I've been streaming on Forge. Okay, I think all those are set. Let's just turn these off. Two more. There we go. So, oh, that went into me, didn't it? Did you see that? Something grew and it picked it, but I picked it up. So, it looks like it picked it and then released it right where the bush is. It didn't suck it out the back. So that might mean that I need to move the bear, the activators to where the bushes are, and vice versa. I need to switch them. Did that go into my person? Wait a second. Let me see if it actually went into one of these. I don't see it. I don't see where it went. Maybe that was a glitch. Let's something was like picked. I saw it and heard it. So let's check these hoppers here. I don't think it can store them in there. Okay, these are all empty. Let's go back down. Okay, check it out. Okay, it's working. All right, nice. We on our first try, I think we got it working. We're up to 34 in there now. So we've got an enchanting table or area. Let me know if I have these bookshelves right, because this bookshelf I have on the block directly behind the enchanting table. But these on the side, I have a block in between the enchanting table and the bookshelf. Because I wanted to put an XP bottler and an auto anvil there. And we have our enchanting area. This is already on my glyph. So, you can see what's it up to now. It's still at 34. So it's very, very slow. So, let's get a better look at it from a distance. Okay, there's a block there I must have broke, or it spit out and it's just bouncing there. Okay, so that's the idea I have. And I'm wondering now if there's a way to maybe use less automated activators, or whatever those things were called. Autonomous activators. I wonder if there's a way to maybe turn on picking sides, so they could pick from like three sides each, and then I could have berry bushes on three sides of one activator. That way I'm using less activators per, like there would be one activator per three bushes. But right now, that's working. I'm thinking we might be able to make it more efficient. I'm not even sure if we really need that many hoppers either, because it's a vacuum hopper. I don't know how many blocks away that it will detect something and suck it in. So we might not even need hoppers directly next to each other. We might be able to, say, keep a space in between each hopper, because even if something gets picked there, the hopper next to that empty space will detect it and suck it in. So I might work on that next. I'm going to go ahead and end this video soon, but that's the idea for this kind of, to have like an infinite supply of experience for, mega enchanting. I wanted the bookshelves, the Biblio Woods bookshelves, to supply a very high level of possible enchantment. It looks like 30. Right? What's this? Auto eject, auto extract. So it looks like 30 is the highest. There's the XP bottler. What are we up to now? We still only have 34. So really, this one, the setup we have now will speed up a little bit once those other bushes get fully grown, right? So this isn't really terribly accurate of exactly how fast this will work. Once those are fully grown, then we'll have a better idea of how much XP we're drawing in per tick, or, how often. But I'm definitely going to expand. I think I'll expand on it anyways. This is just what I was using for scaffolding. So, whoops, those must be above. Just floating up there. I thought I heard more stuff getting picked. Why does it not... Come on. Let me get up there and get another look. How did that dirt get there and I never saw it before? Okay, I think that does it for this video. Those still aren't fully grown, so I have to give it time for them to grow, and then the berries will grow off that a little more often. Whoops. Now, okay, this is for output, so it's still going to suck items into it. Items, not XP, items. It will still suck items into it. Let me double check I don't have these all clogged up. Not that it matters, really. There's lots of space in them. Just double check everything one last time. Okay. Head down. Double check this. 34. Still 34. Well, it definitely filled up. And I believe... Look at that. There's still... That little stuff like that just bugs me. There's a micro block like in there somewhere, I think, and it's just registering as... Oh, is that getting sucked up? Look at that. So it's sucking it up from way over here. I think it's still sucking it up. Yeah. Okay, now I'm getting them. So that's a large radius. Well, I guess we learned that there's a large, pretty large radius. It's not sucking that up, though. That might just be a glitch. Or not. I think I just picked it up. Okay, so that ends this video. Next time, I think I'll expand that a little bit more, but I'll check. Be sure to check the comments. So if you see a better way of doing this, let me know. If you see anything I obviously did wrong, please let me know. And we're also going to be doing a similar method with the activators and ore berry bushes, like the copper, iron, gold ore berry bushes. But those need pitch black. They need to grow in pitch darkness. It has to be pitch black. So I'm thinking of making a farm way down here. Let me go ahead and dig down here. This is where I'm thinking of making that farm. Just down in this area, get it started, and do the same method so we will have essentially an infinite supply of ore. Well, of some ores. Not some of the other ores from different mods, but some of the ores, like copper and iron, gold, some of the basics. Maybe even aluminum. There might be an aluminum and or tin berry, ore berry bushes, so that's still a lot. And then we'll take that and extend it on into other machines like ore processing plants I'm going to build later. But that does it. Thanks for watching. Again, let me know if you have a better way of doing this than me, or if you see something I'm doing wrong. All right, I'll see everybody in the next video. Oh, more came in.